Across the country, the Climate Showcase communities are doing a wide range of projects that demonstrate the value of local government work to reduce greenhouse gas emissions. They cover things from energy efficiency to renewable energy, transportation, waste management, and other projects that ultimately help them save money and reduce their greenhouse gas emissions. The most meaningful impacts are when they're really able to engage their residents and citizens in the work that they're doing.
So our Climate Showcase grant is called Sustainable Transportation for a Sustainable Future. So we are really focused on encouraging individuals to think before they hop in their car to get from point A to point B. Can you carpool? Can you bike? Is it walkable? Is it within 2 miles of your home? So our program is really focused on encouraging the use of alternatives to driving alone that are more sustainable, result in less vehicle emissions and less greenhouse gas emissions.
The impact that the Climate Showcase Communities program is having across the country is really twofold. First, there's the impact that the direct actions that the 50 communities we funded are taking. We invested $20 million in those 50 communities, and by 2015, we expect that their savings from the programs they implemented will be much higher than that $20 million. We also are expecting significant greenhouse gas reductions, criteria air pollutant reductions, improvements in quality of life in those communities. But now we're also seeing that those communities are implementing other things that they've learned from each other, and we're seeing communities outside of the network start to implement things that those communities are doing. And so as that's taking off, the potential for this program is just, is really uncountable.
The EPA funding has kept a very, very important program alive for us. It has made the difference between scraping by and actually being able to grow, to expand our program, build on our successes, save more trips, save more miles, and start reducing our personal vehicle trips in the Salt Lake Valley, in the state of Utah, and also see those reductions in greenhouse gas emissions.
The relationship that we've been able to build with these communities is really unique, and it's something that EPA really wants to be able to continue. And so we're learning as we see the resources, the templates, the communication materials, all those things that those grantees are developing. We're learning so much about what makes this work successful, and are thinking of ways to continue that work by making those resources more broadly available.
It's really important for EPA to be investing in what local governments are doing, because in order to combat climate change, we really need to look at the way that we live, we drive, we work, and local governments are the ones that can actually impact those decisions.